important. You know, small or big. So she's attending YMCA, which is good. You know, like a saving, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's good. Then after I talk to you, then I go more often.
Good.
Used to be once a year, but still, like $50 or every month we pay, like a family, you know, blanket or something like that. You know, bunch. But now I go more often. Yeah. So that's, I think, very important. Okay. Still, you guys young, but think about you know, now immune system going up. The reason why exercise, according to the, his theory and his experience, once you got the exercise, meaning is a muscle move, so generate a protein. So protein is very important to help cell system. Okay? So that's, I think, we have to look at. So then we talk about three elements of our life, right? Our human being. So number one, then the kind of spirit. Spirit and the soul and the body, right? So then this more like a triangle. If you feel so bad or something like that, you know, something, you know, pressure from the office or working or something, then also affects the body, then the spirit doesn't work at all. No matter what, you know, you see good movie, you see good movie, or good book, read, or something, doesn't help. Because the soul and the body is a very strong connection. Then also body something aching, something a problem, then now, you know, spirit affects the spirit too. Then also, of course, soul, you know, something. So then he explained, what about the food? This is a human being, like whole thing human being. Because according to the Bible, then we are spirit. Okay, so psychology major people, they never say that, you know. So I'm a soul or something like that, you know. So then I have a soul. I have a soul. Meaning, think about intellectual way, something very much emotional way, you know, emotional one. So that's all the soul area. But the spirit is different. Spirit, this one's actually connects to the, you know, God, this one. Then of course, then the, you know, body and the soul then connect to this one. But the direct contact to the God. So that's why spirit food is like a prayer. Talk to God, each other. And also body, like we just mentioned already, you know. Body food. Okay, spirit food, this one. And body food. Okay, what's body food?
Healthy.
Yeah, healthy, right? Healthy means you need exercise. You know, that's why you have to change your concept. Exercise is a food of the body. Like I said, exercise and exercise, you know, moving. Now you generate protein, so that's help cell immune system. then stronger. Of course, muscle is a, you know, exercise and bigger and strong. At the same time, cell level going up, you know. So that's why very important, that one. Exercise is very important. Then also laugh is very important too. You know, smile. Then it's okay, sometimes serious situation, okay. But you find out, you know, place to live with love. Okay? So that's one. Then also, of course, then the good food, okay, you know, then especially nowadays, you know, so much different supplement. You gotta pick good one. Then sometimes very expensive and you can't afford something. Yeah. Then the soul, you know, according to the Bible, this one, soul, this is the word of God. Bible or word of God. This is a soul food. Soul food in the United States, especially Louisiana or California, then you know, black people's food. But we are talking about more like our soul, okay? Soul food, okay? So that's why very, very important. And you have to think about, you know, like after that, I reason why I go more, you know, exercise. Because after I read and I talk to you, you know. So that's a kind of influence. You know, young people, most of young people just ignore. Only weekend and then the bike ride or something extensive physical, you know, movement or something like that. But the, like a daily, this is important, very important things, you know, this one. Okay, Bible is very, very remarkable book. Then number one, Bible got no tense, means the time. Okay, just open up the Bible, Hebrew chapter 13, verse 8. Book of Hebrew, like I said, the Bible got no tense, means you know, always like talking about more like a presence, you know, tense. So that's why I want you to just look at the very important portion of the Bible. Hebrew chapter 13, verse 8. Okay. This is the last book of the Hebrew. I mean, the chapter. Okay. When you start reading, yeah.
It says, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever.
Yeah. This sentence. You know, you have to be careful, look at, because I said, Bible got no tense. So in other words, Jesus Christ, the Messiah, is always the same. Okay, this Amplified Bible. Yesterday, today, and forever. Meaning that Jesus is yesterday, is yesterday, and also Jesus is today, Jesus is forever or future. That's what the real, you know, Greek mean, you know, this one. But the English, something the same, yesterday, today, forever, mean something just bundled, you know, one Jesus Christ. But the reality, Jesus is presence, you know, past, Jesus is the presence of course now. Okay? Then Jesus is future. You know, so you have to read it like that. So that's why English Bible itself is not perfect and completed. Sometimes you go back, you know, original scripture. That's why I started to translate Matthew, you know, little my knowledge of the Greek. Yeah. But anyway, found out lots of things. Very, very much, you know, carefully to look at, especially Matthew. I go, okay, now Matthew 28. Okay, verse 17. You got already opened up? Okay, Matthew chapter, well, the last chapter, 28, verse 17. Okay, can you read?
When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted.
Can you imagine? We are talking about the disciple, more dedicated life of the God. So Peter said, I can do anything you want. I die with you. Jesus said, I'm going to die or something. So then he saw the miracle many, many numerous times. Even as Jesus walked in the sea, he face to face the Lucas, right? Then he raised from the dead Lazarus. 4 days he died. Then everybody said, the small smell bad or something like that. But Jesus himself, he taught 12 disciples 3.5 years, and also he taught after resurrected 40 days, day and night. But now, what's happening? See? He doesn't believe, this guy. Disciple won't believe. Only one person believe, you know that. Lady. Yeah, McNamara. She only believed Jesus, his resurrection. Other 12 disciples, some doubt means, I don't think all doubt, you know. Some doubt means something, he's really Son of God. He really God. You know, so that's what the, you know, Bible really creates some doubt. You can imagine, you see, if you meet Jesus, then the next day, what you say, I don't believe, I doubt or something. That's actually human being, very much. So, so that's why, you know, spirit and soul and body is very important, because once you connect to the God, the spirit, doubt is not the face. Doubt is not the presence. Doubt is not the fun, you know. So then the more like a kind of doubt means more like a fear. Yeah. So that's why after Pentecost, then everybody now filled with the Holy Spirit. Then people will of course believe in Jesus Christ. You know what's happened? Magdalene Mary, she got spiritual warfare and deliverance. Seven demons come out. So no demon come out. But Jesus never